Shoot Your Shot podcast, back at it again, episode 22. Jeffrey Aima joining us, back with us. Jeffrey, how do you feel to be back?
It's good to be back.
On the Junior Bowler episode, 22.
No, Jimmy Butler here, okay? None of that.
So let's start off talking about your time playing basketball, George Fox. How was that? How was the experience?
It was a good year. It was a good year. Definitely had some ups and downs, but we finished the year strong, making our conference tournament. And, I mean, I had fun with the guys. We had a good squad this year in terms of his personnel, and learned a lot, expanded my game, and it was just like it was a great experience, especially traveling. I think the best thing about college basketball, or at least one of the best things, is traveling and being with your teams. Like this year, I got to go to Colorado, L.A., Idaho.
Yes.
Different parts in Oregon, Seattle. So just like going around is definitely dope.
W.
All right. Let me get to the NBA talk. First topic, Jaylen Brown's been in the news lately for supposed trade request. I'll read you the full quote, what he said. So someone asked him about his future with the Celtics. He said, "I don't know." He said, "As long as I'm needed, it's not up to me. We'll see how they feel about me over time and how I feel about them over time. Hopefully, whatever it is, it makes sense. But I'll stay where I'm wanted. I will stay where I'm needed and treated correct." So,
do you think if you're Jaylen Brown,
do you like want out from the Celtics situation right now?
After no. This year?
Bro, they can win a ring this year.
That's exactly.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah, I'd see how it goes. Like, I'm not giving up the chance to win a ring just because you know.
After this year, obviously, because he's still locked.
Bro, his argument is valid. Like, the Celtics fans are they're the most toxic fans. I mean, other than Lakers fans, but now the Lakers fans.
Yeah.
But Celtics are toxic, bro. So I get where he's coming from, and they tried trading him, bro. That's like a pride thing, it's an ego thing.
But I feel like at some point you gotta like try it out. He's been in Boston like as a number two option his whole career, so at some point he's gotta like try out like what happens if I'm the number one option on a team, like how much higher can my ceiling get, you know?
Well, if you're Jaylen Brown, where do you want to go?
Well, honestly, if I'm him, if this year doesn't work out in terms of like if they're not in the finals this year again, or at least if they don't win the championship, I think he's got to test the waters in free agency or whenever he can. I don't know his contracts and how all that stuff works, but he's definitely got to test the waters. And for teams that he could play on, I mean, he could always join another team, like form a big three. I don't know where exactly that could be, but
I'm thinking like him as a number one option somewhere. Like
number one option somewhere.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want that like option. Where?
I don't know, somewhere like maybe the Pelicans.
Honestly, what the Pelicans? Well, would he be the number one option? No, he wouldn't even be the number one option. He probably won't be the number two option.
What?
You got Zion and Brandon Ingram there. You got Zion and Brandon Ingram.
Okay, he'd be above CJ, but they have CJ
I'm taking Jaylen Brown.
Yeah. You're not getting many shots.
I'm taking Jaylen Brown every time over Brandon.
Brandon Ingram is him. Don't sleep on Brandon Ingram.
He needs to go to the Knicks.
But is he gonna win though? Like, yes, he can be that number one option, but he's not a player that can lead a team to a championship.
But say like you think the Celtics are favorites, right? Or like top two at least.
Yeah.
So if they win this year, he already has a ring under his belt. No one's gonna put pressure on him for not winning. So if he can go to somewhere else where he can be the number one option and raise his career individually.
If he wins this year, he's got to double back.
He's got to double back.
But if he doesn't, he's got to leave.
I feel like he'll get a taste of the championship. Yeah. One more.
I mean, the Knicks aren't bad. I think that's not a bad option.
Like, bro, he's averaging.
You could be first option.
As a number two option right now, he's averaging like 26 points a game.
He's a beast.
That's crazy.
Wouldn't this be Luka, Kyrie, and Jaylen Brown?
Bro, the Mavericks Mavericks are horrible right now.
Yeah, what would they even trade for him, bro?
Shit.
What do you even trade?
They'd have to trade so much.
Imagine having Kyrie and Luka on your team and you're like outside the plane right now. That's like
But I'm saying not three. Jaylen Brown, Kyrie, Luka. That's a ring.
We don't even know if Kyrie's going to be in the Mavericks next year.
I think he'll stay there for a while.
The Mavericks took a big ass risk trading for Kyrie, and
I have a question for
Jeff. It's not looking good.
Is Luka a top five player in the NBA?
For sure.
Who would you have? Like, what's your top five list?
Top five right now.
Why'd you say no for the clip?
Top of right now, well, I was just being honest. I don't know. Well, it's going to be – I wouldn't say – I'm not going to put this in, like, no particular order, but I think the top five players are – you got to go Embiid. You got to put Luka in there, Giannis, Tatum. And then fifth, I mean
– KD. Interesting.
KD. LeBron?
LeBron.
Curry?
I love LeBron. Like, I'm a huge fan.
No.
But – in terms of like
playing, yeah, the we know you're a huge fan, man.
Yeah, we know.
But
cue the clip.
Yeah. But in terms of like producing like stats and like how the you know just getting buckets and all that, I wouldn't say top five. I think there's just other guys. I mean, you could even put Jokic because KD's hurt right now, so it's kind of hard to put him in the top five. But or I put Jokic as that fifth guy, in the top five.
Not bad.
I mean, honestly, I'm a huge Embiid fan too. Like recently, like he's been getting buckets.
MVP over Jokic.
Embiid.
Oh, this has to be Embiid's year. If Embiid doesn't get MVP this year, ridiculous. He should have at least one already.
That's true. I agree with that.
Like the year Jokic got his back to back, one of those isn't that's Embiid's.
You think you think the games, because like I think Embiid didn't win one because of how many games he played. Do you think that should play a factor in like your MVP votes?
For sure. Regardless of injury or just like maybe load management, I think you got to play a certain amount. There should be a minimum. There probably is a minimum amount of games you can play, but I think that does play a factor. Is I think it's important.
There isn't a minimum, but there's talks of them. They're going to vote to make a minimum. Like, you have to play a certain amount of games to even be considered for any of the awards.
What do you think a good, like, number should be for games played for, like, MVP? Like, minimum.
Like, 65, yeah, I'd say.
Like that 60, in, like, mid-60s, that 60 range.
Mid to high 60s, yeah, I'd say.
For, like, every award, are you saying just for MVP?
Like it's for all the awards.
All right. Do you think?
Hold on, I want to go back. Sorry, I want to go back to the Jaylen Brown thing really quick.
Yeah.
I saw this tweet saying that if both Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown make an All NBA team this year, which at least I think they will, that means Jason Tatum's gonna be up for a $300 million extension, and Jaylen Brown's gonna be up for $287 million extension. A lot of money for two
guys.
That
is wild. Yeah, that's like more than half your team's whole salary roll.
Just for two dudes. Even like Jason Tatum, I would give him that money, but Jaylen Brown, I wouldn't.
Jaylen Brown, you wouldn't give him that money, dude. There's no that Celtics team is nothing without Jaylen.
Yeah,
Brown.
But it's working so well. Like, why would you want to break it up for the Celtics GM?
No, like I don't know when.
They've been kind of mid recently. Or like 5-5.
No, it's because Tatum's been playing worse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, I wouldn't pay. Like, that's just so much money.
That is a lot of money.
So if you're the Celtics GM right now, what are you gonna do?
Try and keep it intact.
I mean, yeah. Well, why would you not keep it intact? What are you talking about?
Like, if I'm the Celtics though, and there's a pretty good offer like out there for Jaylen Brown to trade him, I'd totally take it. Take
like,
it before you have to pay
what
him.
What offer would you? Why? Like, why would you trade? They're literally doing.
Because, but you gotta trade him before you pay him.
I think he's super.
They're
undervalued.
Doing too good to trade anyone.
He's undervalued, Jaylen Brown. I don't think they value.
It's like saying Miami Heat should have traded Chris Bosh in the middle there. I mean, like before they won a championship. I think it makes no sense.
Wait, what?
It's like saying the Heat should have traded like this is a random example. Like let's say the Heat, right? They won two championships. They won two rings. before they won a ring, that's like saying, oh, let's trade Chris Bosh away. Like, we're winning all these games. Like, we're coming up just short. Like, let's trade away one of our key pieces. And Jaylen Brown's an even bigger piece on the Celtics.
But yeah, that's not really the same thing, because Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum have been together for way longer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, even more so.
And Chris Bosh, like, think about it. They made the finals every year they were together. All four of those years.
They made the finals.
So at that point, you can't
get rid of it. Yeah, I'm talking about early on, though. I'm talking about when they first lost to Dallas, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but they were still making the finals. Like, if the Celtics just made the like just, you know, what just happened
you know,
with the Celtics,
you know damn well there wasn't a second thought in their mind after they lost to the Mavericks that they weren't going to run it back.
Yeah, exactly. So why would the Celtics not do the same?
I mean, are you comparing that Heat team to this Celtics team? Basically,
I mean, they are running it back from last year, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
And they got better. They got Malcolm Brogdon too.
If they fall short again, I don't know. Might need to do something.
Joe Mazzulla is doing a good job.
I think if they fall short again, they gotta do something too.
Like a big change or small change?
Small change.
I mean, yeah, try small change, but
Al Horford is a good player, but his time is ticking.
Old.
By the way, always bet the under on Al Horford rebounds. Bet the under.
All right, bro. Anyways, do you think the play-in tournament's a good thing for the league right now?
Yeah,
I still don't think it is.
Why?
Because I'm not saying just because I'm a Lakers fan. Like, oh, we're in the play-in, blah blah blah. It's mainly because I never understood it. I still don't understand it. It's kind of like
when he was like the 1 seed, 2 seed, he was like, yeah, I love the plane. Like, it's such a great idea. But now, like, we're struggling. He's like, bro, the plane's the stupidest thing ever invented. He's like, I don't know who created it.
Yeah, I think it's good personally because, like, all those teams, like 8 through 10, 7 through 10 even, like, out west, actually 7 through 11, they're all still competing, like, trying to get into the plane. If it was just, like, top 8 teams, then those other teams wouldn't be like trying as hard. You feel me? Because they're trying to get into the 60 too.
It's good. It's good for like views too. It makes it more interesting and like more fun to watch.
Exactly.
Kind of like March Madness. Like the first four, you know, shit like that, or the first round games. Like,
who doesn't want to watch a one game elimination? Like,
yeah.
Exactly. Oh yeah, of course. Like,
everything's online.
Yeah. That's super nice.
Like, it ends up being a situation where like a 10 seed and a 9 seed are like 10, 15 games behind a 7 or 8. Like, they should make like a games behind rule. Like, because they shouldn't even qualify if they're like a certain amount of games behind. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We haven't had that yet, though.
Exactly. But, like, I would kind of, to me at least, I would hate if I was the 8 seed and then say the 9 seed like was 5, like 4 or 5 games behind you. That's a lot of games behind you. And then boom! All of a sudden, like, you have a play-in game, and you're like fighting for your life. Like, I would hate that so much because, like, we were obviously way better than that team. We won more games,
okay,
three, four, five more games.
Prove it then.
No, I'm just saying. Like, in the case if that happens,
yeah, it's like prove it on their team.
Yeah, in any game,
but then 7 and 8, they get double elimination. You know what I mean?
Well, but still. And also, you have to play another, like, really tough game before the playoffs. So you get in the playoffs, you're already tired and stuff, while these other teams are well-rested.
Think about it.
Kind of unfair for you.
Maybe it's different for this year because we haven't seen what the playoff picture is going to look like. But realistically, whoever gets a 7-8 seed isn't going to beat this 1 or 2 seed. Maybe this year is going to be different, but most
cases. Like, you're telling me a 7-8 seed of, like, let's say the Mavericks and Lakers, bro? Like, I would not want to play
either
of those
maybe
teams.
Out west is different, but out east, like, it doesn't matter. Whoever's going to play the best.
Out east. Which, I mean, yeah, like, usually, almost every year, just except, like you said, like, this year is different because every team in the west is pretty good. But most years, yeah, 7-8 seed, they just kind of lose in 5. But, I mean, still, you never know. It's happened before.
Yeah, that's true.
Question. All right, who are you taking, Austin Reeves? Tyler in a 1v1, Austin Reeves or Tyler Hero?
Austin Reeves is cooking that boy.
I won't say cooking. Like, if it's
Like Austin Reeves, bro.
Why is this even a question? Why is this even a question?
Austin Reeves, like, that's a backyard barbecue, dude.
Bro.
I think it's a question. If honestly, like, kind of what Tigran said, if Austin Reeves gets hot, he might.
Austin Reeves is not getting. Austin Reeves is not getting the ball back. I'm sorry.
Yeah, obviously,
it's 21-0.
Bro, obviously, Tyler Hero is a better player, but we're saying in a one-on-one situation, like, anything can happen.
Bro, Tyler Hero is cooking him. Tyler Hero is cooking him.
If Austin Reeves gets hot,
I'm taking Austin Reeves 21-16.
Put some respect on Austin's name,
bro. A little closer than that, but I'm still taking Austin Reeves.
So all three of you are taking Austin Reeves or Tyler Hero in a one-on-one.
Yeah, okay, I wouldn't say like that's going to be like it's like a 50-55% chance of Austin Reeves winning.
100% chance.
One of them is a top five clutch scorer in the fourth quarter in the league and averaging 21 points per game.
I know. We talking about
buckets. There's two things Austin Reeves is better at than Tyler Hero. It's maybe defense and free throws, getting to the free throw line.
And shooting and passing.
No.
And he's also just a better white boy.
Tyler doesn't like to drive the ball, from what I see.
He's scared. Austin Reeves, though, that boy would be going at Giannis one on one. He crossed Giannis one on one. Does Tyler Hero do that?
No, that's true.
What's the farthest Austin Reeves has been in the playoffs?
What does that have to do with a one-on-one game?
I'm just saying. What has Austin Reeves proved in a playoff scenario?
What is Austin? Nothing. We're not talking about a playoff game. We're talking about a one-on-one game. You know,
yeah, I'm we're saying, not talking about career saying, wise. We're talking better, about player the individual. Individual.
Yeah, Tyler Hero is a better player. Individual.
Yeah, this isn't about who's the
individual
better player.
Give me Austin Reeves.
All right, that's kind of crazy. That is pushing it.
Give me Austin Reeves. I'm taking him.
That's pushing it.
You're literally only making this comparison because they're both white. Next topic. All right.
I think that Giannis is a top 12 player of all time.
What?
No. What? Dude, stop.
Top 12. Stop.
If we're talking about like just pure skill.
Why are you saying why is top 12? That's still random.
It's not random at all because the top 10 is like, you know what I mean? Like he has to do more like in terms of,
bro,
you know,
he has one ring.
Because listen. Bro. Giannis, two-time MVP, two-time DPOY. Who? Bro, I would pick Giannis over – name a top 10 player, please. Who would you rather have on your team, Giannis or Tim Duncan? Please be honest.
Tim Duncan.
You would rather have Tim Duncan on your team than Giannis.
Tim Duncan, yes.
No.
Yeah, bro. No. Yes.
Hey, respect to Tim Duncan. He's a legend. Top 15-time All-NBA defensive team, NBA MVP, 5 rings. Like, he's done it all. Who would I rather have lead my team? To a chip, Giannis Antetokounmpo, bro.
Are you top 12 with no bag?
What do you mean no bag? He
okay.
plays on a
okay. Giannis plays like it's a you're saying okay. Listen.
Giannis plays like it's a mini.
Listen. To saying top 12 and saying you're saying top 12 or you're saying who would you rather take on a team? There's two different arguments.
Okay, if it's a discussion of who would I rather have on my team all time, Giannis is probably top 7.
Yeah, that's two different arguments. Tim Duncan's ahead of Giannis all time because of his accolades.
Okay, but can we just sure accolades, yeah. But if we're talking about like who would I have on my team, it depends on how what you do as your go rankings, right? But if you're being honest, bro, like okay, I respect Tim Duncan again. He's underrated. He's a top 10 player of all time. Who would I rather have on my team? I'd rather have Giannis on my team. Giannis didn't have Tony Parker and Manu Ginobili. That's all I gotta say. He had Drew Holiday, Chris Middleton.
You're acting like they're bad players.
They're great, but they're not Manu or Tony. So,
Tim Duncan was a dynasty for 20 years.
But in today's
the Spurs were a dynasty.
In today's NBA, though, Chris Middleton and Drew Holiday are phenomenal players.
I never said they weren't.
But those are guys that you want on your team. So honestly, obviously, all timeless. Maybe they're not Manu Ginobili or whatnot. Or Tony Parker, but still, those guys.
Bro, I don't think it's ridiculous to say.
Honestly, equivalent to those.
I don't think it's ridiculous. I don't think it's ridiculous to say I'd rather have Giannis.
Cooney.
Hold on. Tigran, I'm going to list off players. You tell me if you'll take Giannis on your team. Yep. Tigran, you hear that?
Yeah, list off players.
I'm gonna name players and see if you'll pick them over Giannis.
Who I would rather have Giannis over.
Okay. LeBron James.
LeBron.
Michael Jordan. Kobe Bryant,
Kareem.
Magic. Stop.
Ah! Stop. That's a tricky one, right? That is a tricky one.
You got stumped at Magic?
Bro, see, if I have to think about it, bro, who would I rather have on my team to win the championship, Magic or Giannis? Bro.
Magic.
Oh, that's hard, bro. That's hard, right? That's hard. Oh, my God. Sure, out of respect to Magic, I'll say Magic. Sure. Next.
Who else? Well, you already said Tim Duncan. You got your opinion on that.
Yeah, I'd rather have Giannis than Shaq.
Larry Bird.
Giannis.
What? Can we run that back? This guy said you'd rather have Giannis over Shaq.
No, I'd rather have Giannis on my team than Shaq. I'd rather have Giannis on my team over Larry Bird.
Giannis over Shaq's crazy.
Is Larry Bird a deep boy? Is Larry Bird a deep boy?
Why would you
have
Larry Bird
a deep boy? Is Shaq a deep boy? Who's better on defense? Giannis. Who's better on offense? It's a tie. But
Hold on.
Giannis can. Giannis is more of a versatile player on offense.
Someone call the police.
All right, how about okay?
This is not ridiculous.
How about Hakeem? Hakeem.
I love Hakeem. Hakeem's the most underrated player of all time. But on my team to win a chip, give me Giannis. What are you talking about?
How about this? Wilt Chamberlain.
Okay, I can't really say anything about Wilt, but I feel like Giannis is today's Wilt, if we're being honest. Like, I can't imagine if you put Wilt in the NBA today that he'd be doing any better than Giannis is doing.
He'd be doing what Giannis is doing.
How do you know? Were you watching the Wilt game live?
Have you seen any of those clips or any of the stats, bro? Look at what he does.
Okay, do you want me to bring up the argument, David?
That he played against multiple Hall of Famers in his career.
All right, bro.
The whole argument that Wilt Chamberlain and Bill Russell play against plumbers, just so you know, the average height of the NBA back then is taller than it is today. You can't use that argument.
Hey, if you put Wilt in the NBA today, Giannis would be a better player than Wilt.
If you put Wilt in the NBA today, he averages 40 and 20.
Bro, what is wrong with you? What are you doing? No, he doesn't.
I would pay so much money to see Jokic try and stop prime Wilt.
Bro, Giannis would destroy Wilt.
I want to see Jokic stop him. Embiid stop him. Look at Rudy Gobert, bro. He would get destroyed.
Rudy Gobert slander from David?
No.
We can agree on that. Rudy would get destroyed by Wilt. Rudy would get destroyed by Wilt.
Dude, Anthony Davis wouldn't be able to play for 2 months after playing Wilt and won the game, bro. All
right, bro. That was
no one would stop him. I hate Wilt Chamberlain slander, bro. It's so stupid.
You're telling me it's not slander. I'm saying Wilt would be Giannis would be a little better than Wilt today.
People who said he played against plumbers, that he played against short white dudes, bro. Like, no.
All right, bro. All I gotta say is he wouldn't average 40 and 20. That is ridiculous.
He would go nuts.
He wouldn't be better than Giannis is today.
What happens if Jokic doesn't make it past the second round again?
We already talked about this. Why are we pushing the same narrative?
No, I'm talking about this.
He doesn't.
Next topic. Nobody cares.
What happens if Embiid and Harden don't make it past the second round?
Next topic.
Yeah.
No, I actually want to know. I actually want to know your thoughts.
I'll still have the same thoughts about him.
Yeah, same thoughts.
What's changing? I don't understand.
Why are we talking about the same thing?
I'm just saying, brother. Hello,
We gotta have the clickbait takes. We gotta have the clickbait takes.
I'll set up this question better. I'll set up this question better.
Yeah,
this is a good question.
Yeah, yeah, who would win in a 1-on-1? Austin Reeves.
That's a good question. That's not a good question. All right, here's a good question.
Can we talk about Marsh Madness? Shut up.
We'll talk about it later.
Oh my god.
Who do you think's under more pressure? Harden and Embiid or Paul George and Kawhi?
Paul George and Kawhi,
because they haven't done shit.
What has Embiid and Harden done?
Kawhi's not under pressure because Kawhi's already a proven winner. Paul George is more under pressure.
What has Embiid and Harden done?
The Clippers are overhyped, bro. They were hyped up so much more than the Sixers.
This is their second year together, Embiid and Harden, and obviously they need more time, and the Clippers have been together longer. And last year, or the first year, Harden was a little bit injured. They weren't together. They weren't a team as much. And this year, with Embiid playing the way he is, I mean, he played the same last year, but he's playing a little better this year. I think this year is different for him.
Mm-hmm.
So, Mark Rendis.
Talking about SDSU real quick.
Let's go.
K-State?
Cue the music.
They're out now, so this doesn't hit as hard, but...
True. You should have released it before.
Not
good. Go to lunch and enjoy this community. I won't sit on the bros, but I'm muted. Can't feed them, that shit ain't gonna ruin me. I'm the only one out and I'll do me. I got hoes by the crew trying to do me.
That shit was fire.
But after I seen that, that might be the hardest pregame one up.
Like, bro,
pregame hype music ever.
Bro, Lowdown went up in the charts by like hella. Like it became like what the number?
Yeah,
12?
It was 14th in the charts.
Yeah, well, that's crazy.
All genres. It's crazy what social media can do, bro. Influence is crazy.
What's it called?
SDSU, bro. Best defense in the league last year. They added offense this offseason. Like, oh my god, bro. Like, even I couldn't have predicted this. Like, a Final Four run, that's crazy. Especially for a Mount West team. Like, what the Mount West teams are 0-31 before.
SDSU, bro. West teams are 0-31 not a single one seed made it.
Final Four. Huh? Yeah, they lost 31 games.
Not.
Yeah. That's Boise State, UNLV. Trash.
Not a single one seed made it, bro.
It's crazy. Or 2 seed or 3 seed.
Yeah, or 2 seed or 3 seed.
How about them Zags? I know they lost. They got.
Hey, for a team, I'll defend the Zags, bro. For a team from Spokane to make the Elite Eight, we're just used to it now. We're used to it. For a team from a small conference, Mickey Mouse Conference, if we're being honest.
I mean,
who's the second? Who other than St. Mary's?
I mean, yeah, USF. I mean,
San Francisco. Sure, USF, sure. Was Shabazz?
Yeah, Shabazz.
That was a bucket.
Seattle native.
Yeah. I'd say you have to pay respect to the Zags' name. Either way.
All right. Out of the four.
Obviously, it'd be nice to finally win a national championship, but.
One day. But out of the four remaining teams, who you guys got winning at all? I got UConn.
It's got to be either UConn or SDSU.
Can we talk about how either SDSU or FAU is better be in the chip? Like, that's crazy.
That is crazy.
That's actually insane.
Especially FAU.
Yeah.
What's the other team? The US or
Miami.
Miami, okay. Well, dude, honestly,
Miami won the ACC.
I don't want UConn to win because obviously they beat Gonzaga, but UConn probably will win.
UConn's been so dominant, bro.
You know, we talk about UConn as a blue blood. Because, you know, they win national championships, bro. Like, they might not be as consistent as the other Blue Bloods, but, like, if you look back, they won
2014 against Kentucky.
They won the year with Kemba. They won another year with that's 2014. And then they won another time in, like, the early 2000s. Yeah. Bro, 4 chips in, like, 25 years if they win this year? Is that a Blue Blood?
Villanova
won in 2016. Yeah, I think Villanova
is a blue blood.
They won in 2016 and 2018. Bro,
they,
I think
they fell
UConn,
off, though, because J-Rat left.
What's holding back from UConn being a blue blood is consistency, bro. Because, bro, every time, the last 2 times, and it's even this time, like, they made a run, like, they haven't been, like, a top 10 team, top 15 team in the country, like, on paper. I mean, they might. What are they, a four seed? So that's top 16 mm-hmm. guaranteed.
Honestly, bro, it would be filthy to see like a FAU Miami national title game.
Yeah, like
I mean, you're acting like Miami. Miami's an ACC team, but
two Florida Jits facing off in the final.
That'd be fire. It's gonna be UConn versus whoever.
I just want to say that's impressive that a Miami team, like
with all the distractions in Miami. Yeah, that's impressive.
And even SDSU, like this Sunny City, bro. They're locked in.
Yeah. Yeah. Who would have thought?
Yeah.
FAU in the Final Four.
What?
Who would have thought FAU in the Final Four?
Not me.
They lost. They only won by 1 point in the first round against Memphis.
I think I had them losing to Memphis in the first round.
Bro, people were mad.
Yeah.
They dunked the ball when they beat FDU. Like, okay, like, so what? They're just putting an exclamation point on it. They're just mad because it was a 16 seed. If it was like a 1 seed that they beat, they'd be like, oh my God, yeah, punch it on them.
I mean, low key, it's FAUK because after they beat K State, they mocked Lowdown and they did the clapping thing too, like, after they beat them. That was lucky, fuck FAU.
How would you not? That's like the stepping on thing from my senior year.
Come on. How?
Yeah. If you were on the team, it'd be different.
South Carolina women's team was doing it too.
Yeah, but that's fine because they're girls. Like, no,
they're stealing their whole flow, bro. You got to get your own
shit. Yeah, no. But the thing that FAU did is after they beat K State, they did it, like, after the game. Which, like, in the locker room, like, that's fun.
That's lucky five. That's fine.
Marquise Noel is him. He's a my guy. He's fucking Mr. New York City.
He doesn't fucking know
you. Yeah, hey. He doesn't know you, bro.
He's putting on for all the sub-6-foot guards out there.
That's true.
Keontae, how about the story about Keontae George?
Johnson.
Oh, fuck. George. Yeah, my fault. Not locked in.
He's just hogging the mic.
This is zero ball knowledge. No, I'm joking.
What?
Hey, can we talk about my girl, Haley Van Lith? Kashmir, Washington.
She doesn't know you.
Haley Van Lith, that Texas girl tried saying some BS to her. She took that check like a champ. Like, you know, you see that clip?
W dick ride. Hey man, she dropped 27 against Caitlin Clark.
Hey bro,
we
gotta get someone like relevant on this podcast. Like, low key, bro. Mojack, so Mojack knows Nolan.
Mojack, put Nolan on the pod, bro. What are you doing?
We need to get Nolan on here. Okay, so think about it. Here's our web, right? If I can get Mojack to get Nolan on the podcast, Nolan could get like Drew Timmy on the podcast.
Nolan can get us Paulo.
Oh yeah,
no,
Paulo after the season because Paulo's in play or not.
Hey, we're shouting out nice Paulo respects mode. That.
Oh, they're losing games. He can take
they're
time.
In Cancun but, mode.
Yeah.
I take it back. Paulo, come on the podcast. We love you.
All right. Yeah, no, we love Paulo. We love you, Paulo.
Okay, dick ride.
We go Paulo. So if we go Paulo, then we go to LeBron. Paulo to LeBron.
That's not a connection like that. No.
That was, no.
They played in the prom together.
Okay.
No, you got to go
Paulo's,
like, Paulo's
not pulling LeBron.
Yeah, Paulo. No, LeBron's off limits. We're not getting LeBron.
Dream big. Hey, dream big, y'all. Don't
LeBron.
Listen.
You really think LeBron's gonna sit down, log on to Discord, and fucking shoot your shot 206?
Hey,
hey man.
Hey. We're gonna get it done. We gotta do it for the fans.
No. Person, bro.
Here's the connection: Paulo to DeJounte to LeBron.
Oh, DeJounte, bro.
Yeah, DeJounte and LeBron are close. You didn't know that?
Paulo,
are they? No.
DeJounte and LeBron are really close.
We didn't get DeJounte on here, bro. Wait, actually, don't they hate each other, Paulo and DeJounte? They had beef over the offseason.
They had beef, but they scored.
Oh, yeah. All right. No, but for real, Nolan Hickman, we're going to get Nolan Hickman on the show, and then we're going to get Drew Timmy, bro.
Tim and Paulo.
Drew Timmy would be a fire ass podcast.
Bro, we should.
You say that like he's LeBron. He's a college athlete. That checks know, it. Bro, no, don't put nobody on a pedestal.
Julian Strada, though, I need him on the podcast after that game against UCLA.
Las Vegas hit a buzzer beater in Las Vegas.
Are you okay? If you're Mark Few or if you're any coach, Fuster. Are you drawing that play up?
That was a good play. Good.
No.
Fuck no. I'm attacking the basket.
No, I'm feeding Timmy.
I'm feeding Timmy. Yeah.
Looking for a kick.
Yeah. Timmy wanna. But I remember watching that game. They were winning all boards. So I think they believed that even if Strother missed a shot, they had a high chance of getting the oak board because Anton Watson was crashing the boards. Timmy, they were all getting loose rebounds.
Apparently Julian Strother told the coach to make that play for him.
Yeah.
Because apparently they work out in practice.
And Amari Bailey hit that shot before. Amari, Amari, where your mom at? All right,
we're not gonna get nobody. Jesus Christ. Drake.
Drake. No. Okay.
Okay. That's just like, you can't talk about it. Somebody.
All right, mom.
Yeah.
Amari, if you're seeing this, bro, I'm a huge fan.
Don't.
Where your mom at?
All right, bro. Anyways, moving on. I got a game for y'all.
Oh, game.
Is it on YouTube? This goes on YouTube?
Yeah.
What?
I'm in the W. All right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Huh?
You're posting YouTube Reels, right?
YouTube Shorts. YouTube Shorts.
Yeah.
So bucket hat. All right. What's the game?
W hitter.
Ready.
All right. So basically, each of you,
coming close.
What?
I have 12. So basically, I'm gonna give you three words, and those three words connect to one NBA player.
Okay.
All right. And there's 12. Okay. There's 12. So whoever gets the most right, you get a pat on the back.
Woo! All
right. So just yell it out whenever you know it.
Okay.
All right. First player. The three words are injury, flower,
Anthony Davis,
MVP.
Derrick Rose.
The L game.
Let's go. 1 point for David. Lock in. All right. Next three words. Sing.
I said Derrick Rose.
Panther, dance.
Say, you said sing?
Yeah.
I thought of an Indian dude when he said that.
Gupta.
All
right, bro. All right. The
casual racism is crazy.
You
said Gideon. Yeah, Singh is like an Indian last name.
Gupta.
You watch Outer Banks.
No, it's not that Singh. It's Singh.
You retard. I know. Wait, say it again.
Singh, Panther.
Oh, Victor Oladipo.
Yeah. All right.
What?
Jeff, you gotta sing.
What?
Jeff,
sang a song.
Jeff, you gotta tighten up. He's a singer.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And a dancer. He's on Dancing with the Stars. All right.
I didn't know that.
Next three words. Lock in. Tattoos, clothes, and Jenner.
And what?
Devin Booker?
Yeah. Not Devin Booker.
Dude, there's like 50 of them, bro.
Tattoos.
Travis Baker.
Clothes. Jenner.
Yeah, like, I don't know.
I think it's Travis
Barker. J.R. Smith.
How is
Blake Griffin
attracted to Travis Barker, bro?
Wait, what?
Low key, I like
clothes.
Maybe the bad boy vibe.
No,
clothes.
Yeah, tattoos, clothes, and Jenner.
Jordan Clarkson.
Correct.
Boom.
One up. All right.
Wait, who do you guys think the baddest Kardashian is? Jenner's included.
Kim, or no, Kylie.
Base take.
Yeah, I was Kim, bro.
Kylie's like all plastic, bro.
He said Jenner.
Do you see Courtney when she was younger?
I'll take Kendall.
No, not young. What? No. You know what I meant? Like when she was like 21, 22. You know what? All right, bro. Why am I even defending myself? This guy's literally. I was like trying to get a clip.
All right. This is a harder one. Three words.
On this podcast, I'm like,
three words are original, defense, and six.
Lou Will.
Nope.
I don't know.
Defense and Lou Will.
Oh, yeah. Kawhi.
Original defense in six, like the number. It's like six.
The number six.
Who wears number six? Luol Deng.
The first word's a big hint.
Original.
Yeah.
Original.
I don't know.
Bill Russell.
No, it's for current players.
Oh,
that was a good guess. I mean, yeah, current player, original
defense in six.
I don't know.
The defense. Who's a good defender?
The six is also a big hint.
Bro, what is this guy talking about?
Six? Who wears number six?
No, right? It's not their number.
It's not their number? Is that how many points per game they average?
Six man. Jaden McDaniels.
Nope.
Well, how's that original?
Yeah, but yeah. I was thinking six and defense. He's
Jaylen would be original to be the first one.
Is it a six man? Wait, how is it six?
Give us another hint. Who does he play for?
He plays for the Raptors. Right. He plays for the Raptors, doesn't he?
That's what the six stands for.
Yeah, I know. Okay, hold on. Fred VanVleet, Scottie Pippen.
Scotty Barnes.
Scotty Pippen's on the Lakers.
Well, Scotty Barnes. Yeah, what am I talking about?
That's Scotty Pippen.
Scotty Barnes?
Yeah.
OG. Original OG, baby.
OG.
I mean, respect OG, but.
That's all right, great. David got 2 points. Thank you. All right.
Woo!
This one should be easy. Three words are three, China, and brother.
Oh, Yoda Watanabe?
LiAngelo Ball?
No. LaMelo? Is it not that dude on the Nets, Watanabe?
LiAngelo Ball's a good guess, though.
What are the three words?
Three, China, and brother.
Bro, what are you on?
China?
Jordan Poole.
What?
Like Splash Brothers?
LeBron, China. Yeah. LaChina.
Jeremy Lin.
David was close. Let's get at least said it.
Yuto Watanabe. What's the dude on the Nets?
No, it's not.
Yuto Watanabe.
No.
The dude, is he not on the Nets?
China.
I don't think it's China.
This guy, David just said something. Bro, like, that was, what? Like, David was down to two players, and he's good players together.
What? What's his name, bro?
David, you're actually retarded. All right, y'all, I'll give up.
No.
China. Is it not Watanabe? Who's that guy on the net,
bro? David, you're off the road. You're off the tracks again, man.
I said you two Watanabe.
No, you said something
bro?
After that. You said something after that.
What did I say after that? I said Jordan Poole. Clay Thompson.
Yeah. Clay Thompson.
China Clay, baby.
Three was for 3-point shooting, and brother was for Splash Brother.
Yeah, I thought it was Splash Brother for Jordan.
You literally said Splash Brother, and then you said you don't want to know. What the fuck is this guy saying? All right. Next three words: Christmas, defense, and deer.
Giannis. Chris Middleton.
Brandon Jennings.
You're not thinking about all the words.
Bucket.
Huh?
Christmas. Who plays really good on Christmas?
Defense and you said Bucks?
Deer.
I don't know what you are.
Deer?
Deer. Has to be Bucks. Drew Holiday.
Yeah, Drew Holiday.
How does that make it? Oh, Christmas Holiday. That's four, baby. That's four.
All right. Next three words. There's five left. Charge, butt, and bulldog.
You said what?
Kyle Lowry.
Yeah. That was easy. The butt gave it away.
That's so
good. Y'all are not locked in, bro.
5-1.
No.
Cold. Short and Migos.
What?
He said pool.
Trae Young.
Yeah, Trae Young.
Y'all, dude, y'all suck.
I said cold, short, and Migos.
Cold, short, and Migos. That boy in Atlanta, baby.
Yeah, come on. Even I straight up
gang. I straight up gang.
All right, this one's another easy one. You probably get it off the first word. Young boy, bounce, and gun.
Ja Morant.
Oh, my God.
Morant is out by city, yeah.
Okay, another one. There's two left. Vane, snitch, and lefty.
D-Lo.
Jeff got that.
How did I not get that?
Jeff, I'm not
we're competing.
How many points did I have? I have 3 points.
You have three. What is, I got six.
He's sweating.
How many
questions
left? I got that.
I have two left, actually. I have two left.
All right, lock in.
Okay. Overpay, shooter, and bench.
Duncan Robinson.
Yeah.
Dow, dang. That was good.
Finish first.
When he said overpay, I was about to say Ben Simmons. But...
All right, this is the last one.
Yeah,
this is kind of hard. Panda, contract, and loyal.
Damian Lillard.
Panda?
White, light skin?
Panda. It's a nickname.
No, wait, this ain't... So he's loyal?
Name.
Who the fuck is nicknamed Panda?
Yeah.
Okay, who's been on one team? Dame, Curry, Giannis. Did he say Kenny Golladay? What?
Kenny Lofton. Is...
Oh.
That's...
Yeah.
Zion. Zion built like a panda, that's for sure.
Gotta be racist.
How was that racist?
What? Dude. I got Jeffrey here. I can say that stuff, okay?
Our podcast.
Yeah. What a panda. Oh, it was a good one. We were going back and forth with that shit. What are we doing right now? Panda.
What?
Yeah, I mean, y'all match.
Julius Randle. I took the dub, bro. What do you mean?
What is it?
No. Who?
It's Bradley Beal.
How is that related to
Look
Panda?
Up his nickname, buddy. Look up his nickname.
If his, I don't care, bro. You can shut up with your sports.
You
have sports
reference, bro. No ball knowledge, bro.
Panda.
You got zero Panda. Ball knowledge.
Basketball reference, bro. Get out of here.
Your ball knowledge is not there, bro.
We can talk about Armando Bacot coming back for his fifth year.
We can talk about Caleb Love entering the transfer portal.
Yes, good Caleb Love. He needs to come to you.
If that was me, I would enter the draft after the national championship run.
Caleb Love to Gonzaga. I heard that through the girl.
They have too many guards.
I heard that through the girl.
Armando Bacot made a hell of a good decision. He's getting that NIL money.
Yeah,
Bronny to Gonzaga, dude. Bronny to Gonzaga.
No. Caleb Love to Gonzaga.
I want Bronny.
The grapevine.
I want Bronny.
Who is them?
That's what they're saying. Through the grapevine. That's what they're saying.
Source?
Dude, what?
Source. Trust me, bro.
LeBron's hairline. This is a laugh.
Yeah,
that was a good You've been a good clip, but I'm sold the clip. So,
because you're black.
No one.
What?
No.
Wait, cut that out.
Nothing's getting cut out here, buddy.
Cut that out.
I'll mark it on the clips. 48:10 minute mark.
Cut it out. Let it be known, I love all black people, okay?
This guy just mute himself? Your mic's muted, buddy. Muted. Yeah, it is.
Bunch of idiots.
Your mic's muted. The mic's muted.
So muted. I don't think... Oh, no. Wait, it's not muted. I think... Did you disconnect it? Make sure it's connected.
There we go.
There you go.
We don't stand for that, Diesel.
Chance.
Cancel Shoot Your Shot Bardcast member David Diesel.
He's bigger than black and white.
They're screaming. They killed us for no reason.
Oh, I found this hella filthy thing, hella interesting thing, that Spencer Dinwiddie, Cameron Johnson, and Mikal Bridges have played more minutes together with the Nets than KD, James Harden, and Kyrie.
That's crazy.
That's pretty wild.
It was only injuries because James Harden was injured, so that's why I feel like that's a stat.
Well, it's all around the crew.
Like, I mean, they also just sucked. They also just sucked together. They weren't that good together. Whole
big three together for nothing.
No, yeah, I was scared from that big three.
When I first heard that those news about that big three coming together, I lost my mind, bro. I was like, this is over, bro. The NBA is done for. And then
KD became trash and ruined it again. And then went to another super team like he always does.
What do you mean KD almost won a series by himself against the Bucks.
KD became trash.
Bro, where are they getting this? Oh.
KD, bro, he can't win it without a super team, okay? KD built like a duck.
Bro, KD is a 2-time finals MVP. Put some respect on his name.
Because of Curry.
100. I'm going to start doing that when I say fire takes.
No one would remember KD if he wasn't on the Warriors.
I would have. Yeah, KD. 2014 MVP, 2012 championship run.
I remember KD as
a... Maybe just mad that KD hurt LeBron's legacy, and now people don't think LeBron's a goat. That is crazy. KD, whoa.
Because KD ruined the NBA for like four straight seasons.
He's not the GOAT.
Bron is the GOAT.
Top three for sure, but.
Top two, top and eight. He ain't two.
Oh, God. Oh.
Kobe not top 10.
What?
That's not even funny. What is wrong with you?
That boy shot his shot airballed, bro.
Anyways.
So I'm going to shot and cash that.
All right, bro.
An air.
We have a video. We know that was for the views, and we have a video of him saying he's listing his top five, top 10 players of all time. And he had like Kobe, like.
Four. Yo, Jeff, who's your 2023 NBA champion? And runner up.
Runner up, champion. I'm going the Milwaukee Bucks. And then
who? In the West.
Sorry.
This is for the new. Ask the question again so we can.
Wait, put it in the middle.
Just in case.
I don't want to lean into it.
So, who's your 2023 NBA champion and who's your runner up?
I got the.
Fucking retarded.
That's going to get old, though. Cut.
Did you text that? Who texted that? When? When did you text? Did you have
like a minute ago. Oh. All right. Everybody else get that text? All right. Ask the question again.
Sound effect.
Shut up.
Ask the question again. All
right.
We're finna get bought out by Barca.
So, Jeff, right. I have a question for you. Who's your 2023 NBA champion and who's your runner-up?
What is so funny? I just don't understand what we're laughing at.
Hold up.
What is going on?
All right. Sorry. Ask it again.
Jeff, can we put on a clip of like me trying on the cream on cream fit? No. Just a clip that you should be like, you look like a walking.
Hey, it doesn't look like a cum shot on the podcast.
All right, bro.
No, it actually looks fine.
It looks like a Miami shirt. I'm wearing that.
L after show.
No, hey, we.
Can I get your 2023 NBA for runner up? Yeah, I didn't get a champ. I got your champ.
He said Bucks.
He said Bucks. Who's the runner up?
No, ask it again.
No, bro, just tell me. I don't give a fuck.
The Milwaukee Bucks and
He froze.
And the runner up will be the Nuggets.
That's good.
The Nuggets to the chip is crazy.
Hey Vito.
That man Jokic is not taking that.
Hey Vito.
Oh yeah.
Vito, tell me a fact. Tell me a fact about Tyler Hero.
Huh?
Tell me a fun fact about Tyler Hero.
He grew up in Wisconsin. Damn, bro. You got the whole squad laughing on that one, bro.
Yeah, what's an NBA joke? Let me look up. There's a ba-dum bum NBA joke. Yeah.
How long of a podcast episode? There's no way someone watches our whole podcast.
The
Rocks. Someone's going to make it to the end of it, bro. It's just going to be all this.
Oh, Miami jokes. No, that's
my. Oh, chill. You're giving the listeners ear rape right now.
And I got one. David, get it.
All right, we're gonna wrap up the podcast on this joke. Right here.
I got the drums.
All right, hey, get the drums ready. Hey, David, get the drums ready. What do the Miami Heat and a nail have in common? They're both good till they hit the wood.
Ooh. Nah, we're not ending it off on that.
I'm on one.
Okay, fine, one more.
Okay. What do you call 12 millionaires around the TV watching the NBA Finals? The Miami Heat.
All right. Where?
Oh.
Where were the Lakers again when the Heat were in the Conference Finals last year?
Thank you. What does that say? How do you stop a Miami Heat fan from beating his wife? Dress her in Boston green and white. That one made no sense. I don't get that.
What the fuck? Right. That'll make me even more tempted to be here. What the fuck?
What? Somebody clip that.
Let's wrap it up.
Can we end off on actual good joke?
Oh. Yeah, good one.
When do you get a good one?
Boo. If I had tomatoes, I'd throw them at you.
Oh. Hey, I was wondering, Vito, can the Miami Heat as an organization, can they drive the stick?
Bro. Can we get a non-Miami Heat joke?
This is a good one.
Let it go.
The Miami Heat as an organization, can they drive stick? Like the car? Only if they remove the clutch.
Yes.
Dude, trying to find
Okay, damn,
this one's crazy. Hey,
wait, this is let me tell the story first. Okay. A Heat fan dies on match day and goes to heaven in his deep red and orange jersey. He knocks on the old pearly gates and walks out St. Peter. Hello, mate, says St. Peter. I'm sorry, no Heat fans in heaven. What? Exclaims the man, astonished. You heard, no Heat fans. But, I've been a good man, replies the Heat supporter. Oh, really, says St. Peter. What have you done then? Well, said the supporter. 3 weeks before I died, I gave $100 to the starving children in Africa. Says St. Peter. Anything else? Well, 2 weeks before I died, I also gave $100 to the homeless. Anything else?
Wait. Yeah, a week before I died, I gave $100
to the Albanian orphans. Okay, said St. Peter. You wait here a minute while I have a word with the god. 10 minutes pass before St. Peter returns. He looks the bloke in one eye and says, I've had a word with God, and he agrees with me. Here's the $300 back. Now fuck off. All right, bro. I think that wraps it up.
No, I got a good one.
Jeff, come back.
What is the difference? What's the difference between Kobe and time? Time passes. But
Kobe has 6,000 plus assists.
That's actually pretty good.
This has been
who do you call when? Wait, what?
When your life don't work like they used to before.
Wrap it up.
Hey, can we wrap this up? Can we wrap this podcast up on another segment of Lowdown?
Oh yeah.
Of what?
Lowdown.
He's not.
This has been Shooter Shot Podcast, episode 22.
This is actually one of my favorite episodes we've ever done.
Yeah.
It was going to be the most clipped episode. All right, turn it up, turn it up.
I'll be the coach.
I know, he'd be looking zesty as fuck.
My whip cuts a 50. I'm frozen.
Sugar Shop Podcast, episode 22. We'll catch y'all next
time. Let it go in my city. Peace.